Tell me what you can hold when you take your last breath on earth. What have you the world to show? Let it go.
Good afternoon and welcome to Bhikkhu Di, teaching the Vasa after the Radha. And we welcome you for more weeks. We will have 1 year of the Sangha age or moral DA. So I'm happy, unbelievable team, the winner of Dharma bring you here. And my coaching Bhikkhu Di yet arrived from Vietnam here about 10 minutes before you reach here. Last night, I cannot sleep because yesterday I had the video YouTube and I see the human treats human worse than the animal. And they are with the mixed police. When the boy, something wrong or whatever, play, and they tied up the boy and put him motorbike with no helmet. And two of them and turn, so I try to put my body to override it. Can I stand? Cannot, very painful. And they played the game. After that, they threw the boy down and broken the legs and died. So what going on then? Did they, if you do a good thing, the people hide. But when you were betting, only 24 hours, 4, 5 container, 7 million can see that actually.
So, I'm 就是看了网站呢，就是放出了这个片段，在网络里面呢，刚才的就是因为这些警察人员呢，就是抓到这些在家人，然后看他是怎样的折磨这些犯人，其实可能这个男孩子可能犯了很小的错误，但是呢，这些警察呢，就把他可以说是不是当人呢来对待。 我在网站里面你看他是把那个犯人绑着手还不要紧，当他放上这个摩托车的时候，而是帮他倒立下来啊，让他好像一个就是动物这样把他倒立下来，最后呢他把他丢在那个路边，这个人就死了。所以想你看这些作为啊，真的不是人的，不是人为的，这些身为警察人员。 他是要爱护这些人民的，但是反而因为自己的这个权利，他来剥削人的生命，最后呢，这个人肯定掉下来，一定是死的。所以所说的做好事情，有时候呢，可能很多人都不知道，但是呢，像现在做坏事情，肯定现在科技很发达，只要一个手机，他就可以把它放成这个网站里面，很快的所说的24小时，它可以传遍每个世界角落，让人们看到这一幕。
2 days ago, I have one YouTube about meat eating, and I see very horrible to treat the animal. And one man, he worked an animal farm, and the pizza, many small like cats, he tucked up and hit the head, and for sure the blood come out, and two very badly. So what I feel, I cannot stand because I'm too heavy. My heart is pain. Because the mosquito died, I have to get the tissue and cover the mosquito or the bee or somehow I can knock the butterfly like a coffin to go to baby. And I use the yellow rope to cover that. So what going on then? I see the men, I treat the men not only war, to slaughter, but they play the game. So actually, so last night 2:30, I find out when I come down here and I see the fan work. So I think someone forget the fan. So I come and I see Sue, she is asleep here because she waiting for the driver come and she pay for the driving money for Piguri. So I told Sue, very tired. I don't want to come back to this world. Very ugly, very sinful world. Why do people treat the people like that? I die and go further. And I show her the video clip yet now, all of you can say. So try, brother, sister, really, this world is not made for us anymore.
所以最近前两天师父也是在网站就是看到这样的片段，就是他们就是如何宰杀那些小猪啊，所以讲他们这些人就是因为要就是小猪可能他们肯定是说可能他们就做成母猪，所以讲小小的猪呢，他们是如何去杀它？他们不是这样杀，而是说他们整只猪呢就把它丢在地上，让它摔死了。所以讲，而且肯定这样摔哦，是满地都是血的。所以说看在师父的眼里真的是很悲哀，我所说的慈悲，我们连一个小蚂蚁小蚊子这些我们都要尽量的爱护他们，反而说师父说看到这些蚂蚁呢死的时候呢，他还要跟他埋葬，好好的跟他埋葬，是吧？反而一个这些动物仍然为了这个口福啊去伤害这些众生啊，真的是觉得心很痛啊！这个世间为了这个贪欲啊、欲望啊、刺啊，而做出这些所说的这些行为，你看，更加伤痛心的是说，人与人之间啊，对待大海这样，你看，我们他们当根本不是当着人这样对的，你看他们可以说一个活活的一个人，可以把他摔死下来，而且不用去任何的负责任。所以说你看后来做完就是因为睡不着，在等地不一会来后来看到就是其实住在楼下跟，然后就是跟他们就是跟他谈了一些话，就是说很伤感的，就是说这个世间啊，在这个世间里面所说的看到世间一切的透彻的时候，肯定啊我们已经对这个世间没有任何的这些留恋了。所说的为什么我们要修行呢？要出这六道轮回啊，而且是说要回去这个净土，那里才是究竟的。这所说的现在世间真的是世事，每个角落都充满着这样的一个这些看到使人心痛的事情。所说的回到一个净土里面，那个才是真正我们得到安宁的。
不谢谢那，是帮马来西亚到海南 ，is the country now unity， but。Not easy. If not lucky, you know, last night I talk with the immigration and the information office, not the Vietnamese lady, yeah. Vietnam had to go back. So when we practice the Dharma, if we are not have righteousness, we're not right path, we have to come back to this world. Not easy to go.To heaven, not easy to achieve the Sotapanna and Arahant, or go to paradise. So, this is we learn. And yesterday, Ali, we should read about question and answer 7. Today, we will say number 11. So, teacher and Ali will share this and I explain a little bit the end, and we put our efforts to practice to get out the net.Of the ignorant.
所以你看，真的是所说的，像昨天这个比丘尼，他在这个关口那里，因为一些小小的缘故啊，所以说他就是有这个障碍，不能够出这个关口，所以讲还要麻烦到就是他们当这些本地的这些越南人去翻译。告诉他们，解释他们种种啊，最后他才能够回到来这里出关。所以讲同样的，我们人也是一样，所说的我们人如果说要投生，要断这生死的轮回，真的是要积极啊，要积极的修行。而且所说的我们要投生去西方极乐世界，还是所说的你要证到这个果位，还是说你要出这个生死这个六道轮回，我们都要下功夫啊。所以讲当时说的要为什么师父就强调所说的要好好的把握修行依自己的这个善缘这个所说的这个功德
然后投身自己要去的地方。
所以呢，昨天我们这个佛法问答呢，今天我们再继续的，就是关于这些明灯光祖师的开示。
Question number 11. We have met monks and nuns who are patient, kind, and compassionate, but who eat after midday and they handle money. On the other hand, there are monks and nuns who do not eat after midday and do not touch money, yet have other habits. What is your comment?
所以这个是这个问题是说，我们曾经亲近过有耐心、善良及慈悲心的出家人，但是他们并没有守过五不十戒，而且还亲自接受金钱。相反的，有些出家人严守过五不十戒，即不碰拿金钱，但是却拥有坏习惯，请开示。
Such monks and nuns are not kind to you, but to your money. They look upon you as a big fish to be caught. If only they would keep the Vinaya strictly and then transfer all the merits they would then earn to you, then I can say that they are being kind to you. Not long before the Buddha's Parinibbana, he went to the Sava groves of the Vas and asked Venerable Ananda to prepare a couch between twin Sava trees. Then the Buddha had himself down on his right side, mindful and self-possessed. The Sava trees started blooming out of season with lots of beautiful flowers. And the Buddha said, "It is not thus, Ananda, that the Tathagata is respected, revered, venerated,honored and revered. Whatever bhikkhu or bhikkhuni, upasaka or upasika lives in accordance with the teachings, conducts himself dutifully and acts righteously, it is who respects, reverences, venerates, honors and reveres the Tathagata with the highest homage. Therefore, Ananda, should you train yourself thus, let us live in accordance with the teachingsdutifully conducting ourselves and acting righteously.
Good, okay.
嗯，他的问答，这个就是答案，就是这样。他说，这些出家人都对你不善，但是他们只爱你的钱财而已，他们只把你当大鱼来捕捉。如果他们如法的严守戒律，然后把所有真实修得的福报功德全回向给你，那我就能声称他为确实对你慈悲善良。在佛陀入波罗入巴南这个入涅槃之前，他到马拉斯的丛林，交代阿难陀尊子把一张卧床放于双眼间。佛陀专注安详，右卧躺下。当时沙拉树百花齐放。佛陀说道：“任何一位比丘或比丘尼、善男女、优婆塞或善女优婆夷，依据佛陀所教导的方法，严守自身的本分，依正见正法修行，那么这个人就是最虔诚、最高敬仰佛法的人。”阿难陀也必须如此修习，一定要依靠正确的教导，自己严守本分及依正见正法修行。
If you can, please refer to the Gulahatiya Padmapama Sutta, the shorter discourse on the similes of the elephant's footprint.Found in the Middle Land Discourse. There, we find the Buddha talking about how bhikkhus should behave. It is too long for me to reproduce the whole sutra here, but let me just quote some pertinent passages from it. He abstains from enjoying the seeds and plants. He practices eating only one meal a day, abstaining from eating at night and outside the proper time. He abstains from dancing, singing, music, not theoretical shows. He abstains from wearing garlands, smartening himself with sense, embellishing himself with virgins. He abstains from high and large cultures. He abstains from accepting gold and silver. He abstains from accepting raw grains. He abstains from accepting raw meat. He abstains from accepting women and girls. He abstains from accepting men and women, slaves. He abstains from accepting goats and sheep. He abstains from accepting fowls and pigs. He abstains from accepting elephants, cattle, horses, and men. He abstains from accepting fields and land. He abstains from going on errands and running messages. He abstains from buying and selling. He abstains from false weights, false medals, and false measures. He abstains from cheating, deceiving, defrauding, and trickery. He abstains from wounding, murdering, binding, brigandage, blunder, and violence. He becomes content with ropes to protect his body, and with arms food to maintain his stomach. And wherever he goes, he sets out taking only this with him. Just as a bird, wherever it goes, flies with its wings as its only burden, so too the bhikkhus become content with ropes for to protect his body and with arms hold to maintain his stomach. And wherever he goes, he set out taking only those with him. Possessing this aggregated of noble virtues, he experiences within himself a bliss that is blameless. MM 27, I think no further explanation is needed here. The Buddha's words are easy to understand.
The Sutta's discourse on the Smita, the elephant footprint, 就是 Middle Land discourse, 里面可以找得到。 在经典里 佛陀讲述有关比丘要如何注重自己的行为举止, 在此我难以把全文经典写出来, 但是让我抄录一小段有关经文供大家参考。 首先, 比丘缘尽毁坏种子及树木, 还有一日一餐, 禁止晚间进食, 不非食时, 不歌唱曼舞及过往欢听, 不戴花环, 不打扮, 涂香水, 不用游论装饰自己, 不坐卧高广大床, 禁止接受金银财物, 禁止接受未煮过的谷类物, 禁止接受生肉, 禁止接受女人, 禁止接受男女, 奴隶, 禁止接受羊家禽, 猪象牛及马, 禁止接受田地及土地, 禁止当差使, 禁止买卖做生意, 禁止欺骗重量, 测量及假金属, 严禁欺诈及私诡计, 严禁伤害, 谋害, 发牢骚, 抢劫, 掠夺,
及暴力行为。他只能以善衣来护身，一个钵用来栖食养生，就能满足自己了。无论他们走到哪里，都是以善衣衣钵伴随，做自己。这好比一只鸟儿，有两只翅膀随身，到处飞翔。其双翼就是它的唯一负担。比丘也是一样，它只需要袈裟来护身，以托钵栖食来养生，就能满足了。无论到哪里，只要衣钵伴随而已。拥有了这个高尚的德行，他自己会体会到无过错，即不会被他人诬赖的乐极。这个就是一个 quote MN27。佛陀说的法已经清楚回答了这个问题。
OK, I just heard yet to be one part of our better than one question and answer. And today, in the middle of the class, the Buddha gave a very simple. Soon I become bhikkhu until today. I always remind myself, my property is twofold of one pole, not two wheels. And my teacher say, if you trust in the money, stay in the worldly life, become a billion or trillionaire. You work for the landlord work for the bank. The bank work last day, cannot bring in the bankruptcy. So you want to invest in the Bank of Maurice or the Bank of the Society. So that's why I not trust in the money. Because of the world here, so much suffering from A to Z. Everyone, a little boy, when he got no money, naturally. But when he know, he will suffer. And our A the same. Some I knew that nearly 100 years old, the money still in the pocket before die. And the bhikkhuni, she told about one of her our A's teacher, great teacher, near to my home. Same thing, he had operation a few and the jury number to the platinum partner, but before he last return, he still hold the money pocket. So the Buddha teach because the monk we have to follow to practice. The Buddha cannot practice for us. Even our mother, father, our brother, sister cannot. Only they can show us like a finger to the moon. We have to walk on the path to reach to the moon.
所以在这个经典里面哦，你看这个就是，这个中部啊，这个 Middle Land School 就是有讲到说关于出家众是如何如法的修行所说的。所以讲师父所说，这个是修行者就是要像哦，这个经典里面佛陀说的，就是所说的要善衣衣钵哦，因为你身体就是说你出家修行呢，就是要放下任何世俗的东西呀、比如说这个善你的善衣衣钵，这个钵就是你哦去栖食哦，你的袈裟就等于说是你的一个翅膀，你不论去到哪里，你有两只翅膀，就是哦飞得自在，没有负担。所以说好，就是说世俗的人就不一样。世俗的人就是为了工作，而为了去耕田，然后得到这些收获，然后就是有得到这个金钱，所以讲人们就会更把这个钱看得很紧，就会把它储藏在银行里面，然后但是最后呢，就是有一天离开这个世界，他还是想念这个金钱，他挂碍着金钱，到最后呢，他就说就会被这些金钱而奴隶着。所以讲，同样的，我们也可以看到很多的例子，就好像说这个越南里面哦，这个比丘尼，他也曾经去遇见过一个长老，但是长老虽然说身为长老，但是呢，就是因为在金钱上方面呢，他还是牢牢的守着这个金钱，从男的身体病了，老病死的时候呢，你看，身体最后呢，还是所说身边呢，还是挂碍这些钱。所以讲这些钱呢，使得他肯定了不能够自在的。所说的修行，就是说要放下一切，真正的才能够处理的。
You see, our Buddha teaching different with all the religion. He said, come to see, not to believe. But today, we believe too much. We believe our teacher. We believe in the book, in the doctrine. We believe the holy text. But we don't know. We have to investigate. Is it really Buddha teaching, real Buddha world? Or someone by reading, by design, they change, they add on, they delete that. So Buddha say in Kalama Sutra, 10 point there, do not believe what you heard. Even we heard the Buddha say with the investigation. But today you see that one group to another group, one religion to another religion, sect and tradition. To map the world is not the better place, but worse. No, the place is holy now. So I tried the best and the best, and I will point out what Yesu teaching in the Bible, similar to Buddha. Similar to Buddha. Because after 500 years, our Lord Buddha Nirvana, and he went to North India, and he learned of the master there, the one who attended some Dharma food, he come back to Jerusalem, and he turned up on the table. He said, this is the holy place, not the place for the market, not the place for the thief to hide. So today, end of Dharma. But we have to try to build back a little drop of the holy water of the Vinaya and Dharma. Otherwise, the world is outside to burn, and in the heart is dry and all gone. Look like a volcano, you know?
所以真的是现在你看佛陀一直强调了，是要我们真的是要深入的明白这个佛法，你才能够修行，才能够真正的得到这个益处，而不是说要相信。所以讲呢，有时候呢，就是现在的人也可以看到很多，就是有些就是修行者，就是他们都是依很多都是依老师所教的。 依自己的这个门派所教的，所以讲他们很多没有深入的去找回这个佛陀这个说的法的源头是哪里，是什么？他们只就是依自己的这个传承，依我老师这样说，我们是这样修，所以讲到最后呢，这个法变质了，到现在已经可以说是而且也可以说很混乱了。 很混乱的，使到我们这些很多人对佛法上就是一知半解，到最后呢，就是没有一条出路，反而越修之越苦，没有看到，没有真正得到圣心的解脱。所以佛陀就讲过，佛陀那个所说的《伽利玛》这个经呢，就是《结摩那经》，他讲的十条这里面呢，很多这些这个条件，就是要我们呢。 所以讲他说的一条是很重要的，说我们不可以轻易的相信的，某某名师说的法，而是要真的是深入的了解这个法是佛陀当时如何解说，而且我们去实修的时候是对自己有利益的，对自己身心都得到自在的，这个才是真正的，我们是依佛而相似的。所以佛说的就是所说的，到现在所说的随依法随依力。
就是一个真正的走向正道的人。Okay,
teacher, you read this part. Matthew 10:34 to 39. Right, Matthew 10:34 to 39. Not peace, but a sword. Do not think that I have come to bring peace to the earth. It has not come to bring peace, but a sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, and a daughter against his mother, and a daughter-in-law against his mother-in-law. And a person's enemies will be those of his own households. Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take his cross and follow me is not worthy of me.
Whoever finds this life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it.
所以刚才这个圣经里面讲到这一点，所以讲他讲的这样多的关系呢，就是所说的，我们因为就是经典里面他解释到的时候，但是人他会误解这个耶稣所说的这个法，所以讲刚才师父强调，耶稣说的法它是跟佛陀说的法是相似的，为什么当时耶稣呢，他要回到这个当时呢，这个印度里面，他去找回啊，找回佛陀这个脚步，后来才发觉他说真的是这个法是跟佛陀是相依的，所说的刚才说的这样久的这些东西，因为他本最后的比喻是说，我们要放下。 要放下，因为我们往往都是会执着，这个亲人、这个家属是属于我的，这个亲人是属于我的，所以讲啊，他们就误解说，哎，这是说，我们跟整个家庭都是有连续关系，但是真正的，真正的这个耶稣说的，就是因为我执，我们执着不能够放下一切的时候，我们被这些东西啊牢牢的捆绑住啊，所以等到最后呢，我们就是因为这些，我们不能够得到自在。
You see, when you heard the word, you should say, I'm not in peace, but swore. Swore with them, right? And I explained before, no one can bring peace for all others. You can bring food, water, 14th offering, or care your children. But the swore with them, swore with them. You practice to achieve that food for yourself. And you use that to slaughter your desire, hatred, and ignorance.
所以你看耶稣为什么他第一段的时候呢，他就是说，他讲你们不可以期望我把和平带来这个世界呢，我真正带来这个世界呢，是一把剑呐，这把剑呢，就是所说的智慧之剑呐，要这把剑呢，就是说要来铲除自己的这些不好的习气。
Why the holy man and say, if some of you love your family member, like your father, mother, your daughter, your son, more than me, not one of me, why he say that? Well, you know what that means? If you look in the black world, it's very ugly. But you have to go in the meaning, the why, and you know that in a way, away from the husband. And home to homeless, more than that.
of the mind. 所以他其实他以这一段呢，就是说，他讲说，就是说，要我们呢，就是说，我们他的意思是说，跟我们自己的家人啊对立啊，其实不是这样的。他所说的最后的意思是说，要我们就是说，要舍下，因为往往他知道我们所说的家庭的这个亲属的缘啊，就是我们人。 本身就是执着啊，执着这些亲啊，这些家属的爱啊，所以讲啊，就是因为这个缘故，我们的身心都不能够得到自在，不能够得到安详的。所以他的意思是说，要我们跟我们的父亲，就是说背道而驰，跟我们的家属，其实他的意思就是说，要我们放下。You
see why Buddha did not stay home to make his father happy when he become a king, right? Why he not stay home to make his ex-wife or only son happy and rule the kingdom? Because he know that either ignorant, the prison to tie up there, a attachment. So he had to homeless to go to searching the truth. And Yesu after 500 years, what he say the same? You have to go home to homeless. And if you tie up to the family, husband and wife, family like mother and daughter, son, reincarnation again. But did they, you see, some of them to learn one way but do another way. And he said, if you're not able to carry the cross, that be destined, you know, someone who stone you or put you on the cross to die for the Dharma, for his teaching, not valuable. If you want to gain the worldly life body, you cannot gain the Dharma body. So 500 years later, and now we find out, Yes, will be good. Yes, will be good. Exactly what he did there, very clear. Continue the path of impression.
所以为什么你看就是同样的哦，看佛哥已经告诉我们是说佛为什么你看佛陀他是王子，你看他也被所说的放弃他的这个王位，而且背叛了他的妻子跟他的父亲，而是说处理这个所说这个王宫，就是要找寻这个真理。 哦，他同样的，他的做法，有时候我们外人看来，其实他以为是说他放弃，其实他没有，真正的是他自己要找到解脱，然后回来要度众生。所以讲，你看他说的，后来佛陀就是因为这个缘故，他自己积极的修行，然后他找到了真理，找到了这个宇宙的这个法的真理。所以讲，他把说出来，就是说，因为我们人就是因为活在无明啊。 活在无明里面，为这个世间呢、啊，为这个世间所说的，就好像我们的家属，哦，就是说我们不能够处理，就是因为这些所说的关系，哦，我们还在这六道轮回里面，六道轮回里面就是一直不能够处理，肯定就是苦的。所以讲，你看耶稣他的说了，如果说谁如果说真正的能够放弃啊这个家属啊。 哦，而是跟着他同道的，就是说这个人才是所说的真正的找到了真理的价值。所以讲，你看耶稣，你看他经过五百年后啊，五百年后，你看耶稣重现在这个世间啊，佛陀涅槃了五百年，哦，你看他从耶稣重现，他说的法是一模一样的，在这个世间他还是跟着佛的说法一样，就是因为我们我执不能够处理，一直在这六道轮回里面生死的轮回里面，一直受这个苦报。
You see this point. When he said the truth for me, it's the same. He said, no father than me. So the people think me is the Yesu, is the fallen man there, but me is the truth. The Buddha the same. Buddha said, see the Dharma, see me. So when my father in Sydney, he asked me, Bhikkhu, my son, my wife that he that his wife, that my mother, your mother and me, who you love more? And I told him, Daddy, you have to work out yourself. If I love you or my mom more than the truth, the Buddha, Buddha means the truth, you know, I still in home, tied up there. So I say, I love the truth. I try and try my best to devote the three wise, desire, hatred, and ignorance. And I will marry to the truth in one day. If the good news, you become a monk, that is the best. You not marry my mother, but you marry your desire that day. I'm meeting your desire. But luckily, my father can pick up the boy. And luckily, he become a monk. You see how good like that? So when we think about the truth, if I were, money cannot buy. Why we greedy for money? Poverty and thin, fame and power. So we have to work now. By the way, do not wait in God, Buddha, Bodhisattva come to practice for us or send us to paradise. We have to build right now movement paradise in our true heart here. The world is crazy, but we're not crazy. The world is so much illusion, but we are living with the mindful and loving compassion.
所以好像在经典里面都有记载，你看所说的，有时候文字上啊，哦，他讲述的就是往往你看好像在这个圣经里面，哦，耶稣一直强调是说，就是谁能够依随着我，他就是得到所说的一个真理。所以讲这个我啊，有时候呢所说的不了解的时候呢，哦，就好像说，哎，跟着某某的名师，跟着某某的老师去学。 所以讲呢，没有深入的了解这个我是什么。其实所说的，好像佛陀也曾经说过，也是有讲说这个我，其实就是一个真理和一个法来的。所以讲他说，真的是所说的，一个人跟着真理去行走这条走说这条道路，就是为跟法相依，跟法为归一处。所以讲我们人，你看为什么佛陀一直强调这一点？他知道我们人就是因为这一点呢、啊，就是说所说的哦，捆绑。
助我们啊，这个种种的这些，你看我们人为什么在这个世间不能够处理的，就是我们还是要在意这些，在意我们的放不下这些，放不下我们。所以讲啊，我要我们说，真的是能要处理这个六道轮回，就是说你真的是时时刻刻哦要依法，要依这个力来真理一起的能够哦。所说的修持下去，所以讲啊，这个才是所说我们能够得到身心啊，身心的这个安宁，身心的这个和平。
Thank for listening, Sri Lama. Now we transfer knowledge from Aman H3. Even my students today, she operation her arm. Transfer knowledge from Jenny Sitter. Mother-in-law, 94 years, passed away today 4 days. And who is that one? Chan Hen Song, huh? Chan Hen Song, the one who in Batu Bahat, Ahmad Jodai. So he saw our attachment. So he can let go and he can get early rebirth. Then again, thank you.
Stop all evil, keep the peace. Of hell shall not claim lives with the five moral precepts.